best a man can get.
Hi, everyone. Good morning and welcome to First Things First. I'm Jenna Wolf. That's the Hall of Famer Chris Carter. This right here is Nick Wright. We have a great show for you today. Tom Brady is as excited as ever for the season to start, even though he's 41. The Sixers locked up Ben Simmons, even though he's got no jump shot. And Anthony Davis is not discussing the future, even though the present makes him very happy. Are you acting out the...
Yeah, Chris doing a little game of charades.
Sometimes we need it. That's where we're going to start this morning. With a little Anthony Davis, who is thrilled to be a member of the Los Angeles Lakers, but what position he'll play, what number he will wear, and for how long. Well, that has created quite the buzz of late. AD saying, quote, "I'm just focused on this season. I don't know what's going to happen whenever the season's over. Hopefully around, you know, mid-June after we just had a parade. I need a couple of days to think, then we can talk about that. But until then, I'm trying to do whatever I can to help this team win this year." All right, Nick, start with you. Is this season championship or bust for the Lakers?
The only reason it could possibly be championship or bust is if you believe Anthony Davis is a one-year rental. And Anthony Davis is not a one-year rental. Anthony Davis has not signed a long-term extension because it would not be in his interest to sign any type of extension, be it a two-year or a four-year or the max amount of years until this coming offseason. Anthony Davis is taking the approach that we saw Kawhi take, the approach we've seen LeBron take in the past, which is we'll deal with free agency when we get to free agency. But right now I'm focused on this year. So assuming that Anthony Davis is going to be on the Lakers for this season and a minimum of the next 3 to 5 years after, of course it's not championship or bust this year. They will have Anthony Davis, the best big man in basketball, over the next half decade. And even if you don't believe LeBron is the best player in the league anymore, I don't think there's anyone that thinks he's not one of the five best, and that even if he deteriorates from there over the next few years, you're going to have Anthony Davis and one of the five best, one of the 10 best, one of the 15 best players in the league alongside him over the next 3 years. So I would argue there is a championship or bust window of the next 3 years that LeBron is under contract. If they don't win a title together, this will be considered a failure. But this season, they have championship aspirations, but it's not the level of if they don't win it this year, they wouldn't have traded for Anthony Davis. They wouldn't have done it all over again the way they did.
Yeah, and when he decided not to sign the extension with the Pelicans knew ultimately, yes, we have to trade him. But also, I know from the Knicks were informed that if they do trade for Anthony Davis, he's not going to sign an extension. So your fan base, so we even see now in LA, I know verbally from the Knicks that they got a heads up, he's not going to sign an extension. So that was one of the reasons why they couldn't make their best offer, because he's not going to sign an extension. Your fan base is going to go through this. Is he going to stay? With the reality, ultimately, he wanted to be in Los Angeles. So now he's in Los Angeles, and he's doing the same thing that he would have done to any other team that would have traded for him. This is their business strategy. They're doing the right thing. Put it to the offseason. It's not title or bust. He's going to be playing for some titles with the Lakers. I think the Lakers, Rob Pelinka, Jenny Buss, they will have constant pressure to try to win a championship. They have LeBron first, got AD, and they will continue to tinker with their roster as long as AD is on the roster. So it's not my belief that they must win this year to call it a success or to be able to sign AD. Where else is he going to go? He doesn't want to go back to Chicago, where he's from and everything.
Well, that's the thing, is he got traded to the place he wanted to be, the place he makes his offseason home. The Lakers don't have a long history of losing free agents, of having guys come there and then be like, I don't want to be here anymore. I know that happened with 26-year-old All-NBA center Dwight Howard, and now some people are worried will happen with 26-year-old All-NBA center Anthony Davis. Those were very different situations. Guys, even though they were the same age, that trajectory-wise appeared to be in very different parts of their career. Anthony Davis seems to be getting over his injury issues. Dwight Howard was just hitting his. But in the NBA today, everything is short-term. Kawhi Leonard just signed with the Clippers for 2 years.
Yeah.
It's very rare you get a guy and you know you're going to have him for the next 5 seasons, and that's the maximum anyone can know they're going to have a guy.
You mentioned tinkering with the roster. How much more do you think the Lakers have to tinker with this group of players, with this roster, for them to be in contention to win a title? And if so, what position do you think is the first they address?
Well, they don't have a bunch of flexibility until you start to see those veteran players that were either traded this offseason. They're not eligible till the beginning of the season to be traded. But right now, they have one roster spot available for them to be in the Kawhi Leonard sweepstakes and to get the type of free agents they were able to get. Rob Pelinka did well. They got a very good roster. They can play for a championship with the roster they have. They will be active as far as in the buyout market, the veteran market. When that comes around, the Lakers will be a viable spot for veteran players, bought out veteran players who will take the minimum and accept a role and have the opportunity to be able to play deep into the playoffs.
There's three rookies on the roster, Zach Norvell, Eric Holman, and Devontae Kukoc, that they have one open roster spot, and one of those guys could be moved in order to open another roster spot. They have another rookie in Horton Tucker, who was a second-round pick. I would imagine he'll be on the roster throughout the year. They obviously are interested in Andre Iguodala, but a bunch of teams are interested in Andre Iguodala. Unfortunately for me, J.R. Smith does not appear to be in their plans, and J.R. will hopefully catch on somewhere, but Kyle Korver's a viable piece. But those are just the guys we know about now. There's always guys at midseason, a team that thought maybe we can contend, realize they can't. They have a veteran on an expiring deal that they can't trade away. Those are the buyout players Chris is talking about.
And there's so much parity right now in the NBA, but you have to look at the big places. Houston will be in the market. The Lakers will be in the market to be able to get, the Clippers will be in the market to be able to try to grab those little players and everything. So the Lakers have situated themselves as good as possible, given that they were in the Kawhi thing until the last minute, the players they were able to get, even though it's not the roster that we thought at the beginning of free agency, how they might. I thought Rob Pelinka did a good job.
And big picture-wise, when you ask, is it championship or bust, I believe Anthony Davis is going to be on this team for a minimum of the next 4 years. So over the next 4 years, the Lakers will have far and away the best and most versatile big man in the West. When you look, there's not a lot of great bigs in basketball, but the versatile big, Joel Embiid, where does he play? Giannis, where does he play? Kevin Durant, where does he play? Those guys are all out East. There's Nikola Jokic, who is an outstanding offensive player, but limited defensively, and that's it in the Western Conference. So even if you're not as high on LeBron as I am, even if you just think he's a top 10 guy, if you have Anthony Davis plus LeBron, you are contending for titles for a minimum of the next 3 years.
Just don't call Anthony Davis a big guy. Takes offense to that. Yeah. We'll take a break. Talk some football on the other side. Is Tom Brady on the verge of a breakout season in year 20? Next on FS1. You can always check us out on the Fox Sports channel on Sirius XM. We'll be right back after this.
He's going into year 20.